Hello, everyone. Mad Mike here. Welcome to my coverage of Major League Baseball, Mets baseball. It's game one of Mets and Brewers doubleheader. And for this first game, we're going to have Jacob deGrom on the hill for the Mets. Let's take a look at the lineups for both teams. Luis Urias will play third base, bat number one, then it's Yelich in left field, bat second. Adames plays short, bats third, then Navarez catching, batting fourth. Avisail Garcia, right field, bats fifth. Peterson, second base, bats sixth. Herrera, bats seventh, plays first base. Then Jackie Bradley Jr., center field, bats 8th, and Burns, the pitcher, bats number 9. Mets on defense, from left to right in the outfield, it'll be Dom Smith, Nimmo, Conforto. Then infield, Alonzo, McNeil, Lindor, Guillorme, from first to third. Tomas Nino will be doing the catching, and Jacob deGrom will be pitching. First pitch is 2:10 for this first game. Then first pitch for game two will be 7:10. And debating between Game 2 of the Mets doubleheader and Game 5 Stanley Cup Finals for later tonight. Ram is superhuman.
Grande with a $5 grande crush bag.
These Lima Bean commercials are overplayed. I have not seen Practical Jokers. Does everyone at SNY watch Impractical Jokers? Tell me that. Please. Here comes deGrom. To have the live chat up for this stream. It's time to get back out there. For me and my sunrise bench coffee for $2. I know the looks on the bucket. Let's dance. Be amazing. Be generous. Because YouTube Studio isn't doing me any favors right now. Thank you.
last couple of starts. Gave up 2 runs against the Phillies, gave up 3 against the Braves, but then retired 18 in a row and settled back into superhuman quality. Pitching in the sunshine today, which he is the best in history at. So he gave up 4 on runs in his first 12 starts and 5 in his last 2. He's sinking as we speak. 0.95 ERA as he begins the day. Luis Urias leads off.
First pitch to Urias. Up and in with that fastball. 1 ball, no strikes. And we are underway in Flushing. Ball 2. Quinn Wolcott at home plate calling balls and strikes, then it's Eric Box at first. James Hoy, second, Tripp Gibson, third. Pop up, foul. 2 balls and a strike. Deep left field. John Smith is back, but that's gone. Yipes, man. Number 11 for Arias. 1-0 Brew Crew. Jacob knew it.
Hit a home run last year in the short season. He's now got 11 this year. It's the 4th leadoff home run to Grom's allowed his career, but his first since 2019. And so he starts the day in a hole once again. Here's Yelich, 0-for-4 in the series opener. And he takes a fastball upstairs for ball 1.
Upstairs to Yelich. 1-0. Check swing, did he go? He did. Ball on the strike. And 1-1. Swung through that one, it's 1-2. He struck him out! To Adamas. Strike 1 on that fastball, 99. Ah, landscapers. Adamas will file this one back as I try to drown out that lawnmower. The 0-2. Got him! Strike 3! 2 away.
Side swing of Urias
Urias, watch his back leg. Just collapse and almost like he's just grounding that back foot into the ground to get that extra power.
Last leadoff home run against deGrom, Scott Kingery of the Phillies 2 years and 2 days ago. Here's Omar and Narvaez, who homered in the first game of the series.
First pitch to Narvaez is outside for a ball. 1-0. The 1-0. Check swing. Guillorme at third, throw to Alonso at first will end the inning, but not before the Urias homer. A run on a base hit, which was the homer. No errors, no one left. Milwaukee 1, Mets coming to bat. Not advisable! Definitely not advisable right here. So, do not do that. Do not do that at all. And this is one dumb commercial. I know they're trying to emphasize the partnership between Geico and MLB, but that is just wrong on all levels. Nimmo back in the lineup. Very lefty heavy lineup. Lefty heavy lineup against Corbin Burns. Brandon and Nimmo will lead things off for the Mets in their half of the first. These are both 7-inning games. Game 2 will get the first pitch at 7:10. And I'm not a proponent of split doubleheaders. I really am not. Low outside. Ball 1. The split doubleheader, you're paying for a 9-inning game. You should get 9 innings. In the game you paid for, if it's in a doubleheader now, it's 20% shorter. Ball and a strike.
Most of the fastballs that Burns throws will cut. He'll also throw his sinkers, but the cutter is something of a natural fastball release for him. You'll see if he's on today, be a lot of broken bats.
To left field, but this one will go foul. 1-2.
They don't consciously cut the ball, but it cuts when they release their fastball naturally.
You know, most of the guys that cut the fastball is because they have a very strong middle finger, and that's where the ball comes off. That middle finger with a lot of pressure, that's how it gets that little cutting action.
In the opening game of the series. After facing Burns as a starter for the first time, he faced him in relief for 2 1/3 back in 2019.
1-2 coming. 2-2. Two on the way. Full count. Is that fastball missed? Three balls, two strikes. So they'll try again. Can't still fold a 3-2.
It's mostly because of the weather tonight. The weather is supposed to be iffy, much as it was last night. So if they scheduled a straight twi-night doubleheader at 5 o'clock, they would have risked not playing either game.
Oh.
And that's why they moved this game up. They also couldn't play a day doubleheader because that would have been unfair to the people who bought tickets for tonight's game, who bought tickets for a 7 o'clock game. So. Though it's not a perfect solution, that's why the decision was made to play a split.
The gap in center, base hit! This is going to go for extra bases. Nimmo already in scoring position with the tying run at second base in the bottom of the first. Well done, Brandon, well done. Brandon Nimmo being Brandon Nimmo. Hustle and bustle of Brandon Nimmo in New York. Can we re-sign Nimmo and Conforto? Thank you. Make it happen, Steve Cohen. Make it freaking happen, Steve Cohen. This brings up Francisco Lindor. No bunt from Lindor, ball one. Lindor do what he's got to do. Gotta let Francisco Lindor do what he's got to do. Outside for a ball. That curveball missing badly. 2-1. Again. Counts 2-2. Another 2-2. Behind third, this one will drop, base hit! Nemo being with round third, and he will score! RBI single for Lindor, and we're tied at one. Francisco Lindor does it again. Brings up Dom Smith. Lindor to man at first with nobody out. Fastball just over the outer edge of the plate, nothing in one. Burns checking the signs. Come set, pause, throw to first, and Lindor's back. Burn set. Lindor with lead off first. Throw to first, and again, Lindor returns. Oh, missed bunt attempt. It's nothing in one. Oh, called strike three. Smith punched out, one away. So his cutter at times, Gary, can serve as a backdoor pitch because he throws it so hard. Brings up the polar bear, Pete Alonso. First pitch to Alonso. Cutter outside. Pete went after it. Nothing in one. Ooh, Lindor. Nearly picked off, but he's back in time. Alonso's now driven in 10 runs in his last 9 games, and those are the full season projections for the 30th. Base hit, Alonso! The Mets' third hit Lindor to second there. So first and second with one away. Brings up Jeff McNeil with Michael Conforto waiting on deck. Curveball in for a call, strike one. The 0-1 way outside. Ball one. Ball and a strike on Jeff McNeil. The 1-1. Oh, and it hit him. They're going to rule a wild pitch there. Alonso to second, Lindor to third. But it looked like it hit McNeil. I'm going to see this again. Did it hit him? It did not. It looked like it did from my perspective. But it will go as a wild pitch. So 2 men in scoring position with one away. Base hit scores two here. Foul. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Foul into the catcher's glove. That's strike three. Brings up Conforto. Foul tip, but right into the catcher's glove. It was a big strikeout for Burns, but now he's got to deal with the hard-hitting Michael Conforto. So it's left to Michael Conforto. Michael had an RBI hit in the Mets' seventh inning rally on Monday. But the hits have been hard to come by for Michael since coming off the injured list, just 5 for 37. Chance to do some damage here with Lindor at third and Alonso at second and 2 out. Burns already 22 pitches deep into this first inning. Lindor get a little dash down the line to try and get in his line of sight. And the first pitch curveball is in for a call strike one to Conforto. Nothing in one. Burns with that first pitch can't be overturned.
I think Conforto is going to see more of that maybe in this at bat. The Guillorme behind him. He might not catch a center cut, a pitch at this at bat. Lindor keeps walking further and further down the line with Urias playing well off the line.
Nor trying to induce a balk. Curveball just caught the plate, nothing in 2. Alonso Lindor will be running here on 0-2. 0-2. Foul. Still nothing in 2. I'd want that 0-2 pitch back if I was the pitcher, but I'm not. Guillorme waits on deck should Conforto continue this inning. Right at the second base, throw to first is in time, inning over. A run on 3 hits, no errors, 2 left. Through 1, we are tied at 1. It'll be Garcia, Peterson, and Hira. Two up for the Brew Crew in their half of the second inning against Jacob deGrom. First pitch to Avisel Garcia. Broken back. Grounded to Lindor. Throw to Alonso. One gone. Need a defense when you've got a guy like DeGrom on the hill. Because he's Jacob DeGrom. Just on the inner edge of the plate. 2 balls and a strike. Check swing. He did go. 2-2. Jake has 2 strikeouts already today that give
1,497. When he gets to 1,500, if he does it today, he'll be the second fastest ever to get to 1,500. Yu Darvish got their fastest, Jacoby one start behind him. 2-2 coming. Slapped on the ground, Guillorme.
Throw to first in time. It's a 5-3 putout. Two away.
Brewers sitting in first place by 6.5 games in the National League Central on the strength of their 11-game winning streak that got stopped on Sunday by the Pirates. Mets handed them a second straight loss on Monday, but that win streak was the second longest in franchise history. Milwaukee, far and away favorite to win that NL Central now and get to the postseason for a fourth consecutive year. The three straight years is already a franchise record. Just cast a hero.
Hero will take ball one.
All four on fastballs. Let's see the numbers. Not ugly right now for a guy who had a terrific rookie year 2 years ago. He chases the slider and it's 1-1.
Ball on the strike on Hero. Slider. Chase that one. One and two on Keston Hura. Fastball, slider from deGrom. This AB. Topper back to deGrom. Throw to first in time. 1-3 put out to end the inning. deGrom gets him in order. On to the bottom of the second. 1-1, our score.
Yeah. I rewired everything.
With what?
I don't know, some stuff, it worked fine.
Just right would be better than fine, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
That's why Toyota Service Center technicians use genuine Toyota parts. They're designed specifically for your Toyota to work just right.
Sounds really good.
Woo!
Toyota Service Centers. Keep your Toyota a Toyota. Let's go places.
There's no better place to bet baseball than on FanDuel Sportsbook. It's easy to find your bet and lock it in just a few simple taps. Give me three or more answers. You got it. Only FanDuel lets you bet same game parlays. So you can turn a little bet into a big payday on every big league game. Join FanDuel Sportsbook today. Place your first bet risk-free and get up to $1,000 back. What do you call a crunch wrap with double the seasoning beans? A crunchy taco. And a large drink for just $5. No, but it better be grand. Or grande. It's the $5 grande crunch wrap meal. Only a taco.
That's around an 88 and 74 pace right now. Brewers, 94 and 68. Luis Guillorme will lead things off in the top of the second. Guillorme, Nito, deGrom. Bottom third of the Mets order due up. Curveball laid off that time. 1-0. Third base, throw to first will retire Guillorme while gone.
Ballpark app will complete your next visit to City Field. Buy and manage game tickets, redeem
Check it offers access, exclusive content, and much more. Download the MLB Ballpark app today. What's the temperature of the ballpark today?
This will bring up Tomas Nito.
Very still, very humid, 93. I feel very comfortable. Well, you should feel comfortable. It's about 115 in here, right? At your temperature. What do you think of this temperature? Perfect for my body, Jared. I feel 25. It's like giving you a cortisone shot. Exactly. It's Tomas Nito hitting 8 for the order.
You know, lays that, lays off on that fastball. It's 1-0. One as that curveball finds its own.
That's true. Nito's second game is coming back for the Indians. Quick game one on Sunday, went 1-for-3 with an RBI.
No 1-1. Lines up, base hit! Nito will stop at first there, and this will bring up Jacob deGrom. Grum hitting at a 387 clip. High and outside to deGrom. 1-0.
Shows you the value of finding somebody who can speak to you. Speak to you and believes in you. I mean, every hitting coach wants to put you in the right place, and they might say the exact same thing in a different way, and it's the guy who makes the connection who can, you know, spark the fire, and it seems to have done that for Nito. DeGrom's hitting 3-0.
Backdoored him with that cutter, it's 1-1. Brandon Nimmo awaits on deck. A run on 4 hits, no errors on the Mets line score to this point. We're in the bottom of the second. One one. DeGrom trying to bunt, missed that bunt. 1-2. Now you gotta be swinging the bat if you're DeGrom.
So DeGrom trying to bunt for a base hit. Now he's got a 1-2 count.
Two and two. Curveball away that time from Burns. Cutter, cutter, curveball, curveball. From Corbin Burns. Two two. Oh, L6 that time. L4 that time. Line out to second base. If you're scoring at home. Brings up Nimmo. Burns comes set. Nimmo doubles his first time up. Pitch. Cutter in for a called strike. Nothing in one.
No pride, Marley, Davis is the fifth umpire. He's filling in at first base with the doubleheader today. Nick Marley will have to play to the nightcap. Nimmo lined a double to left center and scored the bench run of the first inning.
Golf shot, but this one will go foul, nothing in two.
Well, most days Corbin Burns would lead the spec with a high speed pitch, but this is a deGrom day.
That's a shame. Throw 98, can't even get respect from mobile.
Is there a pride associated with winning the spec with mobile high speed pitch?
I don't think there's any pride in winning spectrum high speed. I don't think there's a prize for it. Especially if you're going up against deGrom. Nimmo down on strikes to end the inning. No runs on a base hit, no errors, man left. We're through two and tied at one. For the Brewers, do up in their half of the inning. It'll be Bradley, Burns, and Urias. Up and away that time. One ball, no strikes on the former Red Sox Jackie Bradley Jr. Bradley's been struggling. 172 average coming in. Slider away. 2-0. The 2-0. First, flip to deGrom covering, and Bradley is retired. One gone on a 3-1 put out. Bare hand. Nice. Now Corbin Burns. Owen 2 on the opposing pitcher.
This guy throws 100 and he doesn't, not sure where it's going yet.
Ball and two strikes.
This is the way I used to hit Little League against the big, hairy 12-year-old. Kid ride a motorcycle that he did. Kelly Lee.
The 1-2. Got him! Third strikeout for DeGrom.
Pitchers are now 0 for 20 with 16 strikeouts against DeGrom. By Google Cloud. Well, the Brewers have struggled with breaking balls, and DeGrom has, you know, been just awesome at getting people out with breaking balls. Then on the other hand, the Brewers have struggled against high velocity this year. Their second lowest OPS in the National League against fastball 98 and above, so. By those standards, Jake should have his own way, but there's nothing given, and certainly found that out with Luis Arias in the first inning. He homered, this time he pops up, and it's...
Lindor will make the grab on the pop-up, so I'd retire. 1-2-3, go to the Brewers. We go to the last of the third. It's 1-1. Oh, Alex, hey. Sorry. Haven't been checking chat a lot. What's up? Nice to hear that Broadway is getting back in action soon. Like, about a month and a half until Broadway gets back. Lindor, Smith, Alonso do it for the Mets in their half of the third. Oh. Darkness, hey! What is up?
Are great, right? When you see everybody in their uniforms along the foul lines, and they get to wear, like, maybe special shoes or something a little different to spice it up. Or, you know, Ronald Acuna, the same thing. Right, you wear the batting practice jersey for the home run derby, that's great. But for the game, that's the great thing about baseball. You don't have to wear generic uniforms because, you know, you don't have to figure out...
Drop the curveball in there on Lindor. Nothing in one. Lindor with an RBI single, his first time up. Yeah, let's get some darkness hype in the chat right now. Ball and a strike on Lindor. Yeah, same. I got on SNY right now. The 1-1. Good curveball there from Burns. One ball, two strikes. going to add darkness as a mod. Oh, good breaking ball. That was a good breaking ball. Yeah, it's blackout restrictions. The local broadcasters have first rights to game to local team games. Yeah. What are you doing there, Lindor? What were you doing there? And they're really hyping up this new season of Impractical Jokers. Dom Smith struck out his first time back in the first inning. If you get swept by the Pirates, I don't think you should even be a baseball team. Because the Pirates are that bad. And 1-0. To right field, going back, still going back. Not back enough, two gone.
Well, the Pirates are a rebuilding team, and they're going to have fits of starts. They've got two really good players in Ryan Reynolds.
Getting swept by the Diamondbacks is even more embarrassing. I don't even know what the Diamondbacks are doing. What in the world are the Diamondbacks doing? Now here's Alonso. Throw to first. 4-3 put outside, retired. We're through three. It's still tied at one. As I've been telling Alex, I'm not a proponent of these split doubleheaders. It's just screwing the fans. But yeah, I understand why the Mets did this one as a split. I've checked the forecast. It doesn't look too good for the 7-10 game. It doesn't look too good between games. So if they did it as a straight, they'd be running the risk of another rainout. And I'd be having to check the schedule for when next time the Mets and Brewers meet up at Citi Field. So this one, I get why the Mets and Brewers did this as a split. It'll be Yelich, Adames, Narváez. Narváez, excuse me. I've been mispronouncing that name this entire time. It's Narváez. How do you go from 85 wins and a playoff spot to to only 25 wins at the All-Star break in the next season, in the next full season. No balls and a strike on Yelich as we start top half of the fourth. Remember, these are seven-inning games. I'm debating between Game 2 of this doubleheader and Game 5 of the Cup Finals. I think Kim's going to be doing Game 5 of the Cup Finals. I'm not sure. The 1-1. Foul. 1-2. Struck him out! One gone. Oh, Blackout Plus Wimbledon on ESPN. Ah. I keep forgetting that ESPN has rights to Wimbledon. And it's always been on NBC. For as long as I can remember, Wimbledon had been on NBC. With the U.S. Open on ESPN Labor Day weekend. This one is going to be well foul. Nothing in two. Got him! Again! Five strikeouts now for deGrom. He's on a 10 strikeout pace if this had been a full 9-inning game. And that is career strikeout, 1,500. Career strikeout number 1,500 for the deGrominator. First pitch to Narvaez, 101! 101 on that fastball, it's nothing in one. The 0-1. Foul on that slider, nothing in two. Struck him out! Three and a half complete. DeGrom now with six strikeouts. We're still tied at one. Jeez! Is it just me or is Jacob DeGrom superhuman? Is superhuman. It's your sleight of hand. It's your great escape. It's your all day, all night tech savvy magic carpet ride. The Hyundai Elantra. It's your journey. Oh, lease an Elantra for $139 a month, or get 1.0% APR plus 500 bonus cash. Hurry in. This year, without your direct game,
TheSportsNY.com.
Join Bet365 today. And with your deposit $10 or more, we'll match it. With up to $500 in bet credits. We use your bet credits to get up to $500 worth of risk-free bets to spend on whatever sport you choose. Download the app now and see for yourself what Bet365 is the world's favorite sports book. Home fourth inning in a 1-1 game. First game of a day-night doubleheader, so this one's scheduled for 7. Jacob deGrom appears to have hit his stride, striking out the side of the fourth and getting up to 101 miles an hour. Jeff McNeil leads off the home fourth against Corbin Burns, who's retired 5 in a row.
First man up in the bottom of the fourth is Jeff McNeil. Pitch. Well outside. One ball, no strikes. Foul. Ball and a strike.
Corbin Burns has pitched brilliantly this year, 2.41 ERA coming in, but the Brewers are only 8-8 in his starts. Brewers were a sub-500 team before Willy Adames got here.
1-1. To center field. Going back. Still going back. Not enough. One away. This brings up Michael Conforto. Luis Guillorme waits on deck. Curveball outside, one ball, no strikes. Whoa! Change up well in the dirt. What were you swinging at there? It's 1-1. Foul. 1-2.
So how's our poll doing so far? Lindor has a majority so far. Is there a right choice voting in this particular poll?
33% each would be a nice way to go, but everyone thinks they're all going to get there.
The 1-2. In the dirt with that curve. It's 2-2. Oh no, strike three called. Burns with 5. Brings up Luis Guillorme. Tomas Nino would be next, should Guillorme keep this inning going. Outside for a ball. 1-0.
Last night he faced the lefty Brett Anderson. He'll probably play the second game. Luis Rojas said before the game, probably not on J.D. Davis this weekend. They were thinking about maybe bringing him back. this weekend, but rather than bring him back for a couple days and have the All-Star break, they'd rather get him some more reps in all probability.
Tied up there. Ball on a strike.
But right now, with the way Yorme and DR and Peraza are playing, there's no need to rush anybody. I get the benefits of being a first place team.
Check swing, that's going to go foul. You think cup final, Alex? I was thinking that myself, but I'm reasonably certain Kim's going to be doing that. I'm not sure, but I'm thinking cup final. Oh! Clang. Yes. Thank you, Ron Darling. Burns comes set. Pause. He kicks and deals. The 1-2. Ooh, just outside. 2 balls, 2 strikes.
Well, it's a 7-inning game. Both these pitchers have pitched to reasonable pitch counts. Both, I'm sure, have their eye on.
I already know I'm going to be doing game 2 of the NBA Finals tomorrow night. Two-two. Oh, struck him out. That's 6 for Corbin Burns. We're through 4, tied at 1. I'm guessing there would be a 5th inning stretch? I'm not sure. But since these games are 7 innings, there would be a 5th inning stretch? That's what it was like at the turn thunder. I'm grasping at straws here. I really am. Oh snap. Marco Andretti says he's close to putting a deal to do some NASCAR Xfinity Series races. Says it's something he's wanted to do for a long time and really hopes they close out on that deal. I'm assuming that Xfinity deal would be for NBC. And I should really do a garage area video on that. And this is per Matt Weaver from Auto Week.
Very funny, Brad.
Motorsports editor of Auto Week.
Every team for every fan for every device.
So I'm gonna have to look into that.
That reminds me of the Dwight Gooden poster on the west side near the Lincoln Tunnel.
Yep.
All those years on about 36th Street or so.
An enormous side of the building.
It was so cool.
Well, Jacob deGrom did not throw a pitch 100 miles an hour or harder in the first 3 innings. He threw 3 of them in the 4th inning when he struck out the side. He's now retired 12 in a row.
Garcia, Peterson, and Hiura. Garcia swings right through that one. Nothing in one. As we get the 5th inning going.
Detroit was kind of a protege of Miguel Cabrera. And Miguel Cabrera is the guy that swears, might be ready to swing. First pitch might be the best pitch you get.
Well, he was kind of the...
July 22nd, August 23rd, and September 16th would be the makeup days. Deep but foul, nothing in two. Yeah. Only problem with August 23rd is Dodger Stadium. They'd have to go coast to coast for that, and I don't think the Mets would want to go coast to coast after rushing home from Dodger Stadium on 22nd. So, August 23rd would be a no-go. The 0-2. The shallow center. Spectacular play by Nimmo! Brandon Nimmo robs Avisel Garcia of a base hit. One away. Absolute highway robbery from Brandon Nimmo. How did he do that? That was absolute highway robbery from Brandon Nimmo. Jace Peterson swings and misses on that slider. No balls in the strike. Yikes. That play by Jacob de... Not Jacob. That play by Nimmo. That could be a game saver. Right there. No balls, two strikes. Back door. One ball, two strikes. Two and two now. Two on the way. To right center, here comes Nimmo. And gone. Peterson, 2-1 Brewers. Ugh. What I would have done if I were deGrom, I would have pitched him high and outside just to adjust the eye level a bit. And then I would have went with the slider. Fastball. Right in the zone. Nothing in one. But we've gone fastball, high and away, changed the eye level a bit. Then slider, low. Get him to chase. Ball two strikes. You're a down on strikes. And there are two gone. Brings up Jackie Bradley Jr. Strikeout victim his last time up. Foul. Nothing in one. Bradley was a ground out victim. Excuse me. Foul, nothing in two. Two to Bradley. DeGrom is due a turning back at the bottom of the fifth.
seven-inning game, which is like the seventh inning of a nine-inning game, you think about hitting for your pitcher when you're down by a run.
Been one of the hardest balls in this game for the Mets. Mm-hmm. And this first at bat for now.
It certainly changes the equation somewhat. Swing and a bat.
Got him. That is eight strikeouts now for deGrom. 2-1 Brewers, heading to the bottom of the fifth. Now, do you think about hitting for deGrom in the bottom of the fifth? He is due up second in the inning. It's Nito, deGrom, Nimmo. Yeah. September 16th would be the best makeup date if tonight's second game gets rained out. Again, I will be checking the weather for Citi Field for later tonight after this game. Tomas Nito will lead things off for the Mets in their half of the fifth. Cutter outside, ball one. Strike one. No balls in the strike. Foul. Nothing in two on Nito. Oh, two on the way. Bounce to third. And he lost it! And that will be an error. Score that in E5. This will bring up deGrom. Now, do you hit for deGrom here? Looks like they are not hitting for deGrom. So if you're deGrom, Do you swing the bat, or do you try to sacrifice Nito over? Sacrifice unsuccessful there. This will bring up Brandon Nimmo. So the right idea, but he popped the bunt up. Way too high. That pitch was too high. A double may score Nito here. Because Nito has good speed. Cutter outside ball one. The 1-0. Check swing, did he go? He did not. 2-0. Lindor waits on deck. Waxed that one foul, 2-1. Cutter, change up cutter, so far from Burns this AB. Counts 2-1, one away. One. High outside, ball three. Pop up. Adames retreating off the glove of Vialich. Oh, they'll get the force of Nito though. Two gone. It was a lose-lose situation for Tomas Nito. Devils will score Nito here. Nimmo, not Nito. Double scores Nimmo.
Chance with a two-out hit. It's interesting, he said this earlier, Ronnie, and it's really true for a guy who has trouble with the stolen base. Burns actually had a pretty good move. It's just the laborious nature of the way he releases the ball to the plate that gives base runners a jump.
Outside for a ball. One ball, no strikes. I'd be stealing if I was a Nemo here. Dom Smith would be next if Lindor keeps this inning going. The 1-0. Cutter in there. Called strike one. Ball and strike. Another pickoff move, and in low A ball, that would have constituted a balk, because that was the third pickoff move of the AB. Yeah, Ross probably told DeGrom, next base runner, you're done. Nemo on the move. Throw to second. Got him. Nemo caught stealing to end the inning. We go to the sixth. Brewers up 2-1. If Nemo had a better jump, inning continues. But instead, it will be Lindor leading off the Mets sixth. Ugh. I can't do the NBA Finals Game 2 on Thursday because that's my turn to do a picture piece for Metsmerized. So I gotta do the Mets-Pirates game. Nothing in one, as Burns will take a strike. Stretch in this game. He's faced 17 batters, retired 15, and given up two solo home runs. Foul. Nothing in two.
Even hinting at a walk. But the home runs right now have him behind.
1-2. Foul.
Questionable start at first base. Just didn't get a clean getaway. Kind of just spun out there with his right and left foot. Looked in. That wasn't enough to be safe at second base.
Tagged by Adamas. Good throw by Narvaez.
Ground to deGrom. Throw to first. One away. Braves and Pirates in delay. And the tarp is down in Pittsburgh.
Orlando Arcia playing for the Braves as we watch the Brewers, a former Brewer who's playing left field for the Braves. They've had trouble replacing the back of Marcelo Zuna. And so Arcia, the latest to get a chance.
Outside for a ball to Urias. 1-0. Tune one.
That's a Brewers have both been good in one-run games this year. Mets are 17-4.
Yeah, I'm getting that feeling myself. They're in the top of the seventh. Well past halfway. Foul. Swing and a miss on that one. 3-2. Oh, that's an ankle breaker. Jake let loose an ankle breaker. Fouled. Still 3-2.
The change of the game plan for deGrom. Very rarely does he throw a fastball due to right-handed hitters. That's something I think in the second half we'll see them.
3-2. On its way. Line shot. That's going to fall for a base hit. So, Urias on first.
Just the third hit against deGrom, and now for the first time, Jake will have to pitch out of the stretch. Big leg kick. This is a good slider right on the corner, but Urias covers it, and that's why...
No action in the Mets' pen.
Hard for me to say that to a guy who's been almost perfect in the first half, but that's a good pitch, not a mistake, and he gets a base hit. Hard out of the box. Was thinking through the entire way, but hustled by Nemo.
Brings up Yelich. Four, six, three. Side retired. That is a rally killer. It'll get us to the bottom of the sixth. Big sell over Pittsburgh, separate small sell, crossing 470 on its way to New York. Oh boy. I don't think they get that 7-10 game in. I really don't. I do not think they're going to get that 7-10 game in. I honestly do not think that 7-10 game is going in because there are some dark clouds over my neck of the woods right now. I think that's part of this smaller cell that you talked about, Alex. I'll be on for about another half hour after the game.
Williams is up at the bullpen now. Burns at 71 pitches through 5 innings. We'll take on the Mets third time through the batting order. This is where teams have gotten to Burns this year. He has paid a third time through the order penalty. Lindor was at the plate when Nimmo was caught stealing to end the fifth. Francisco takes a strike.
Strike one. Slider off the plate. Ball on a strike, as that changeup misses badly. Tune 2.
So when I think of these pitchers that have kind of relief mentality, that are all out on every pitch, there's no place to add on later in the game, third time through the lineup. They've already added everything they have.
Two-two.
And Lindor takes strike three called. Cutter outside corner at the knees, and you rarely see Francisco that upset.
Francisco is mad right now.
Strikeout number 7 for Burns.
Seventh K for Burns.
Wilcott is given a little extra off that outside corner on that cutter. And let's see if he gets a little extra here. Boy, that's there. I don't know about the height of it. Maybe Lindor was arguing at the height of that pitch, but tight game, big at bat.
That was a generous call from the home plate ump. Favored the pitcher there. I wasn't sure about the height of it. That looked to be a ball. So the count should have been 3-2 had it been a ball. Cutter, strike one. Nothing in one. Maybe he should have pulled the trigger. I'm not sure. But I get where Lindor was coming from there. Taken. Ball on a strike. Foul. Oh, swung on and missed strike three. Ball one to Alonzo.
Kind of games that you're looking for your big guy, the big fella, one swing of the bat. Well, the thing is, if Burns gets Alonzo, then the Mets have three left-handed bats due up in the seventh, McNeil, Conforto, and Diorman. That could affect Council's decision as well. Of course, Pete can change that entire equation here. He plays off that curve.
Yeah, Pete can change things right here, right now, with one swing of his mighty bat. Foul, 2-1. That almost hit Alonzo. 3-1. Line shot, base hit! That's gonna go to the warning track. Pete on his way to second. He will stop there. Tying run in scoring position for Jeff McNeil. And that may just affect Craig Council's decision to pitch Burns in the seventh. Devin Williams is in the pen. Oh, and they played the Sabres goal song as a pinch runner will come in for Alonso.
The issue you have here is that in the outfield, Yelich has a good arm, strong arm. Obviously, Garcia in right field's got a very excellent arm. And Jackie Bradley Jr. might have one of the best arms in the game in center field.
So here's McNeil, who's gone 0 for 2 today, struck out and flying out, 0 for 5 in the series. McKinney, the pinch runner for Alonso at second with two out. Mets down by a run in the sixth inning of the seven-inning game.
McKinney will take his lead off second.
Adames playing right behind McKinney so he can't get too far away. And McNeil whips one foul.
McNeil will send this foul. Two outs, 2-0 count on Freddie Freeman in the Braves game. Tough play. Can't make the play! First and third! First and third, two out, tying run 90 feet away. And I lost my cursor again. Oh, my cursor has disappeared. Cursor! Okay. Gotta do Control-Alt-Delete. There we go. Cursor's back. Don't you just hate it when your cursor disappears? Brewers make a call to the pen here.
$2.97 each when you buy three. Stop and Shop. Feed the moment.
Now, Michael Conforto doing some studying along with head coach Hugh Quattlebaum. They'll be facing Devin Williams for the first time. Devin Williams with the
Devin Williams will be the new pitcher.
Had a great rookie year last year. He's been good, but not great this year.
I mean, he gave up one earned run in 27 innings pitched. The one the key for Conforto.
And he will face Michael Conforto.
It's almost like a screwball.
Lefty's hitting .237 against Williams.
So I think what you have to concentrate on for Conforto is that most of the pitches from Williams are going to be middle of the plate away.
Throws his changeup 61% of the time, and it has tremendous movement. He almost wanted to try to not swing at the changeup. Is that got to be part of your game?
He can throw it for a strike, too. It's got great control of it last year. His control of it this year, not as good.
Tying run at third, go ahead, run at first with two out. Conforto 0 for 2 today.
Pitch to Conforto. Way outside of that changeup. It's 1-0. Conforto! Just foul!
Hero barely came off the bag, so if that was fair, it probably would have been an out. It's funny, you don't see first baseman push off the bag very much anymore because of the shifts. So that ball down the line gets covered a little bit better.
Also, with a runner on first and a hit by a run, they don't want to.
One ball, one strike on Conforto. Single scores McKinney.
Tying run at third. McNeil at first with two down. Oh, this happening after two out and nobody on.
The 1-1. Conforto is hit with a pitch. Conforto just got hit with a pitch. Brings up Guillorme. Single scores two.
Guillorme is 0 for 2. He was overmatched by Burns' cutter his last time up. Corbin Burns, 87 pitches over 5 and 2 thirds. 6 hits, 1 run so far. No walks, 8 strikeouts, a wild pitch.
Burns is charged with the mat, 2nd and 3rd. So if they cross, they will be charged as runs to Corbin Burns. First pitch to Guillorme. Change up. Just in there. No balls on a strike. Second, throw to first will be in time and the threat will not come to pass. Mets leave the bases loaded. I would have let that pitch go. Or through six, 2-1 Brewers. It's Adames, Narvaez, and Garcia. Mom, honestly, I would have let that pitch go. Because all you're going to do on that pitch is ground it.
$5 that meal, only at Taco Bell.
All of this started when we discovered the benefits of local raw honey for our family.
And then you said, hey, you know what, this is a business right here.
We went out and started to sell it.
To help us keep going, we got to chase business into the banking account. It's more than the bank account. It comes with quick accept, which lets us take car payments anytime, anywhere, and get same-day deposits at no extra cost.
The Mets wasted a bases loaded opportunity. What the freak?
Chance for business. Make more of what's yours.
The story of Mike's hard lemonade begins deep in the jungle with a man named Mike in search of a legend.
We go to the seventh inning in a seven-inning game. Billy McKinney stays in the game at left field. Dom Smith goes to first base. Jacob DeGrom,
oh boy,
going for the complete game. Willie Adames leads off and pops the first pitch to third. Two hopper handled by
Guillorme. May throw to Alonso. One gone. Josh Hader lurks in the bullpen. Ball one to Narvaez. Too low. There's a strike. 2-1. Swung through that one. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Foul. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Got him. 9 strikeouts now for DeGrom. 2 gone. Whoa!
First pitch, slider bounces away.
Bounced away there.
Coming up on the post-game show. Carry out analysis coming up right after the AFWB Basin post-game line. I mean, think about it. For all of these sliders that DeGrom has thrown this year, he's thrown a ton. He has not thrown a wild pitch this year.
Two balls, no strikes.
Precision and power at its best. I was hoping to throw a strike first pitch to that. I haven't seen a hitter make three outs.
Yes, I'm watching that game right now, Brian.
Garcia would be the candidate for that.
2-0 to Garcia. Line to center. Nimmo cuts it off.
So a two-out single for Garcia. And Andre Chase Peterson will play for a return. Center-cut fastball on it is Garcia ahead of the count. So now Peterson has provided the difference in this game. Center field in the fifth inning, his fourth home run.
Now Jace Peterson. Pitch to Peterson. Outside for a ball.
So home run by Peterson is on the slide.
Well, no. Foul. Ball and a strike. Did not like that call one bit.
The fastball he threw into a right-hand batter in the last inning, and that was an arm side fastball. You just don't see a lot of those.
2-1. Foul, 2-2. Glad to see Nimmo and Conforto back in the lineup. Whoa! In the dirt. Ten K's for Jacob deGrom. Last at bat coming for the Mets. Extra innings. They might.
$21,000 in cash back, which I use for new equipment to expand production. What's in your wallet?
Thank you.
got your back, Road Warriors. Because we know you want to get back to going.
Okay. Up for the Mets, Nito, DeGrom, Nimmo. It'll be Nito, DeGrom, and Nimmo in the last of the seventh. And they are up against Josh Hader. He was a target for the Mets over the offseason. Kevin Pillar will pinch hit. Ball one to Pillar. Let that pitch go. It's two balls, two strikes. Peraza will pinch hit for DeGrom. And Pillar swings and misses, one away. Left center field, going back, still going back. That ball is out of here! Jose Peraza ties it up! The bench mob has struck! And the impenetrable wall for the Brewers is no more! Intelligence, brutality. We saw Hader
just blows away Pilar with three straight fastballs after he got behind in the count.
Can you say later, hater? That is a blown save! Jose Peraza! That ball was gone from the second it left the bat! The 0-1. Nimmo swings through that slider. It's 0-2. But Jose freaking Peraza! Two gone. Jose Peraza. Are you serious?
This is what Gibson sees. Well, they made a mistake there. Brandon certainly had a case.
Yeah, Brandon Nimmo had a case there.
Edwin Diaz getting ready for a potential extra inning. Francisco Lindor trying to prevent that extra inning from happening. Lindor drove in the first pen run with a blue single, the first strike out twice after that.
Nice healthy hack from Lindor, but it's nothing in one. Lindor. Lindor. Hater comes set. He deals. Foul. Two balls, two strikes. On the road to 500 subs here. Let's get as close as we can to 500 subs. I'll be doing this game and probably the Stanley Cup Final Game 5. If I don't do Cup Final Game 5, I may see you on Kim's Cup Final Game 5 stream, if she streams Game 5. Lindor to left. Yelich will make the grab. Nice grab by Yelich. We're through 7. Time to go to extras. Peraza ties it up. We're going to extras. 2-2. And sound the trumpets. Here comes Diaz.
Patience.
a place where people, devices, and things connect, where that data creates insights and countless opportunities, all made possible by HPE's Secure Edge Cloud Platform. That's not just built for today, but is helping build your tomorrow. This is much more than the center of innovation. This is the edge of it. Just tell me what I need to know. Where is it?
It's on the beach. The ocean views. It was supposed to be a surprise.
She doesn't like surprises, Dave.
Thanks, Captain Obvious.
Booking a trip can feel dramatic, but with free cancellation, you can't go wrong with Hotels.com. Also, you're out of milk.
Edwin Diaz is on to pitch the top of the eighth inning. Extra innings at Citi Field in game one of the day-nighter. See his numbers. His last outing on Monday, he was not sharp. His control of his fastball was...
It's Diaz time. So sound the trumpets.
A couple strikeouts, but a lot of run. Other changes for the Mets. James McCann stays in behind the plate. Kevin Pillar goes to left field.
And McCann will go behind the plate. Pillar to left. Would this be considered a safe situation? Rowdy Tellez will pinch hit. Lee Tellez, Jackie Bradley Jr. in the pitcher spot. Ball one. Ooh, 2-0. Two and two. Good call there. Came out! One away! Brings up Jackie Bradley Jr. Yeah. Sit down!
Bradley takes a fastball away for ball one. Bradley only one hit and four career at-bats against Diaz.
He's a good fastball hitter, Jackie Bradley Jr. Never afraid of velocity.
Lindor, throw it to Alonso, got him! Two away.
And now Tyrone Taylor will come up to pitch it.
Well, well placed was Lindor. Shaded towards the bag at second base. Made a most difficult play into an easy one.
So now Taylor, who had a base.
Brings up Tyrone Taylor. So, Hader will not be on for the eighth.
Slider that he hit off Diaz in the hole between third and short. Lindor has moved over two steps.
A little closer to the hole against Taylor this time. Hader's in a third, two out, and Taylor fouls
foul.
On the fastball. Nothing in one.
No balls on a strike.
In the bottom of the eighth, Lindor will be the free runner for the Mets.
It's Brent Suter for Milwaukee Brewers.
Aguilera. Smith, McCann, and McNeil coming up. Too high for Diaz, the ball is straight. Infield to the outfield, shades of the left against Taylor.
Oh, 2-1, way outside with that one.
Taylor keeps the inning going. Luis Urias has already had a terrific day. Would be next.
It can't be easy to come off that bench like McCann and just try to pick off 100 mile an hour fastballs.
2-1. And that missed.
3-1. Foul. Full count.
Staying with fastballs against Taylor.
Taylor now has caught up pretty much to the fastball because that's all he's seen. But he does have a hole up and in with that fastball. That's what McGill was able to use on Monday night.
3-2 coming. Too high
ball. Oh, four.
And so Urias will come up with two men on.
First and third, two gone. Brings up Arias.
Now Arias, who provided the keynote in this game today with a leadoff home run against Jacob deGrom. Then had a base hit in the sixth inning against deGrom as well.
Well, deGrom got 2-0 on Arias. Tied up a 2-1 pitch, and now on the 2-2 caught a fastball up in the strike zone. What a start for Milwaukee against Jacob deGrom.
Urias trying to bookend this game. Diaz trying to put down the threat in extra innings. That gave the Mets a chance for a walk-off. Taylor at first has four steals this year.
First pitch.
Urias lays off first pitch.
Urias will lay off. One. 1-0.
Walk to Taylor, the first walk of the game on either side. Rob didn't walk anybody. Burns didn't walk anybody.
Have the grounds crew umpires in Pittsburgh taking notes from NASCAR. Foul back. Ball on the strike. NASCAR will do everything possible to get their races in on schedule.
Taking advantage of
1-1. Defensive indifference. Tyrone Taylor will take second on defensive indifference. Three and one. Oh no, Diaz. Don't blow this. Don't blow this, Diaz! Ball four. Here comes pitching coach Jeremy Hefner. First pitch to Yelich. Oh no! He hit Yelich! Brings in the free runner. Oh my god! Diaz! Wow. What the blank, man? Hit him with the pitch! What the frick? That is uncharacteristic of Diaz to be hitting guys with pitches, but he did so against Yelich. And I think he just blew the game. I don't know what to say at this point, man. I really don't. And he appeared to be in command. But he lost Taylor, the pinch hitter, to a walk. And then he walked to Reyes as well before hitting Yelich. Now Thomas swings to a fastball. It's 2-2.
Stern test here for Diaz. Ever since he's come over here, Adamas has had huge hits for the Brewers.
If you can limit it to one run, you give your team a chance in these extra innings with the free runner. Second career pinch hit home run. And they have allowed the Brewers to take the lead in excruciating fashion. Adamas swings and misses.
Got him. That ends the bases loaded threat. Limiting the damage to just one run.
Brent
Suter will be the new pitcher.
And just the opposite of Josh Hader, who was in with all that 95 plus and the great slider suit. Suter is more of a control pitcher, kind of a soft tosser. And we'll try to get through this Mets lineup with the ghost runner on second. The changes on the infield for the Brewers. Jace Peterson moves to first base. Luis Urias moves to second. Pablo Reyes comes in to play third. And with the free runner Lindor carrying the tying run at second, Dom Smith leads off and takes up an in from Suter for
ball one to Dom Smith. Missed opportunity for Diaz to rebound from poor non-save situations. Foul. 1-2 on Dom Smith. It'll be Smith, McCann, McNeil. In the dirt, 2-2. Dom Smith gets hit with a pitch. Retaliation from Yelich, perhaps.
The Mets left 2-1. I think it got his hand, not his
I'm thinking that was retaliation. James McCannon. I mean James McCann. But we call him the McCannon. One ball, no strikes. One ball, one strike. Knee-high change up there. 1-1. Foul. 1-2. Jeff McNeil on deck. Thank Conforto. Foul. Still 1-2.
Williams put himself in jeopardy by hitting Conforto with a pitch to load the bases, but then got Deorme to ground out throughout the sixth. But Jose Peraza's pinch hit home run tied the game of the seventh. And with Diaz hitting Christian Yelich with a pitch with the bases loaded to put the Brewers in front here in the eighth. And now the Mets trying to respond. Lindor the free runner at second. Smith the first with nobody out. Off, it's just
2-2, McCann lays off that one. I think that was a good take there. McCann will foul this one back. Still 2-2. Lindor the free runner at second. Dom Smith over first after the hit by pitch. Single scores Lindor. Extra bases wins the game. Suter comes set. From the stretch he kicks and deals. Ball three. Full count. So the payoff pitch will be on its way. Three, two. Oh! That was nearly a balk. Should have been called a balk. Foul. Time asked for by McCann. Ball four! Base is loaded! Lindor at third, Donald Smith at second, carrying the tying and winning runs. Here comes the pitching coach for the Brewers. As Jeff McNeil will stand in with a chance to win the game. With nobody out. The base hit will plate both. The tying and winning runs. And who better to have up at the plate than Jeff McNeil. McNeil 1-for-3 on the day. Suter sets. First pitch. Slider, inner half. Nothing in one. Outside for a ball. 1-1. Michael Conforto waits on deck.
That's about a free runner, a hit batsman, or a walk in this inning to load the bases.
1-1. Low in the dirt, two balls and a strike. Suter checking his signs. He comes set. Pause. Now to pitch. Line shot! That's going to be a base hit and the Mets win it! Lindor is in! Here comes Donald Smith! Not in time! Mets win! Mets win! The Mets come back to win it 4-3 in extras! Incredible Jeff McNeil with his first walk-off RBI! The win will go to Diaz. The loss to Suter. No save. Game took 2 hours 46 minutes. Played in front of a packed house at Citi Field. Oh my god! And Jeff McNeil knew he had brought home the winning runs. I don't think Familia ever came out. Familia never came out. The win will go to Diaz. Gosh. But yeah. Mets rally for two in the bottom of the eighth. This is 2006 Mets meets 2015 Mets. Diaz goes to 3-2, loss goes to Suter, he's now 8-4, no save. Brewers 3 runs, 4 hits, 1 error. Mets 4 runs, 8 hits, no errors. Absolutely incredible. Anyway. I'm going to be on later tonight. Don't know for what. Either Game 2 of the doubleheader or Game 5 of the Cup Finals. I will let you know whether I am on or not. Game 2 of the doubleheader is at 7:10. If it's for the Mets doubleheader, I'll be on at 6:30. If it's for Game 5 of the Cup Finals, that starts at 8, so I will be on at 7:30 for that. Anyway, I will see you later. Hopefully. Anyway, rock on, sports fans. Mad Mike, signing off.